throw our trash away, it's as if it disappears, but actually, it's packed into a landfill where it sits and rots for years. Mucking up water, ground, and sky for the animals and plants nearby. And that's why we reduce, reuse, and recycle. You gotta reduce, reuse, and recycle. All the things you buy and the bags and tags that come with them. All those things, when you're done with them, become trash. But if you buy a little less, use a little less, we reduce the amount of trash that we produce. Next up is reuse. Turning something old into something new. It might take some alteration and imagination too. A tire can be a playground swing. A can be, well, anything. Next up is recycle.
Recycle what?
I'm so glad you asked. Paper, cardboard, metal, plastic, and glass. They're broken down into materials to use for other stuff. So remembering to throw your trash away is not enough. You gotta reduce, reuse, and recycle. You gotta reduce, reuse, and recycle.
Are you tired of rocks with sharp edges?
Ow!
Are large, heavy boulders getting you down? Do you wish there was a way you could shrink down your giant rocks and smooth out their sharp edges?
Well, yeah, actually. That would be great.
Well, now you can! Introducing erosion!
Erosion, huh? What's that?
Here!
What am I supposed to do with this?
Just splash it on that rock! Now do it again!
A trillion more times!
Huh?
It might not seem like anything's happening, but as water flows over rocks, it's using a surface process known as water flow to erode its surface, dulling their sharp, pointy corners and slowly carving into their overall shape. The only thing it needs is time, and lots of it. Sometimes it can take years, decades, or even a millennia before you see any significant changes.
Wow, that's amazing!
But wait, there's more! Act now and we'll throw in a second form of erosion absolutely free! Introducing airflow! It flows against rocks just like water and over time wears them down.
Whoa, incredible!
It sure is. And it could be yours, but only if you order now.
I'm gonna go get my wallet!
Erosion. Ask for it by name.
Erosion is very valid. Nothing in this ad should be construed as endorsing, supporting, promoting, backing, sponsoring, advocating, encouraging, aiding, or assisting in erosion. If you try erosion at home and start to disappear, take two aspirins and call me in the morning.
Huh? What'd he say?
Say, Dank, how tall do you think the tallest tree is?
Oh, I don't know. I'd say, it's at least 6 feet tall.
6 feet tall? Are you out of your mind? If that's any taller than 5 feet, then I'm a red-breasted sapsucker.
Wait. If you think the tallest tree in the world is only 5 feet tall, then you're a sucker, all right, but you ain't a bird.
You don't know anything about trees.
Oh, yeah, my middle name is Trees.
All right, that's it. I cannot go birdwatching with someone who thinks trees can be 6 feet tall.
Why, I can't go bird watching with someone who thinks trees are only 5 feet tall.
Fine. Then I'm packing my binoculars and heading home.
Good. Oh my God, please excuse my interruption, but I'm sorry to say that you are both slightly off in your calculations. On average, most large trees can grow between 40 and 100 feet tall, but the tallest tree on record is a California redwood that grew to roughly 380 feet tall. That's taller than a 30-story building!
Yeah, right, lady! And I'm J. Edgar Hoover!
380 feet? This bear must think we were born yesterday!
Come
Come on, Dick.
Yeah, let's get out of here, doink.
This bear wouldn't know a redwood tree for kitchen's sake.
Welcome, class. A tornado is a fast-spinning tube of air. My assistant, Gopher, will demonstrate the formation using my Tornado Simulator ZX9, which lets us observe a tornado in 100% complete safety. Gopher, if you please. When wind near the ground moves in one direction, and wind above it moves in a different direction, it can form a horizontal tube of spinning air. Meanwhile, in the clouds, the condensation that makes rain and hail gives off heat, which makes warm air near the ground move upward. As this air moves upward, it tilts the horizontal tube of spinning air to an upright position. This upright spinning tube of air can then pull hail, rain, dirt, and other things into it. And when this tube stretches from the cloud to the ground, a tornado is formed. These storms can have huge dark clouds, lightning, thunder, large hail, and strong winds. Gopher, what have you done to my tornado simulator?
And that's how tornadoes form.
System called taxonomy, which classifies all animals into groups. Now this system divides them into two basic kinds. You got the vertebrates, the animals with backbones, you know, spines. And then the invertebrates, who also share a common trait, the lack of a backbone, which they don't seem to mind. Now for vertebrates, it's been decided it makes most sense that they're divided into mammals, fish, amphibians, reptiles, and birds. Invertebrates have different groups, and within them there's so many cute and charming guys like butterflies and wiggly little worms. How many kinds of animals exist on Earth? So many. Life is so diverse, and we discover more all the time. Scientists try to keep track, and while we know it's in the millions, between one and tens of millions, we just can't.
Are dangerous, you know.
Oh, sorry, man. No offense.
So, what are you StoryBots doing in my web anyway, huh?
Oh, we're trying to answer a question for a kid named Ava Grace.
Yeah, she wants to know how flowers grow. Well, I can tell you a thing or two about that. It all starts with a simple seed. See? Planting the seed, StoryBots. And it'll be okay down there? Oh, it'll be better than okay. With sun, soil, water, and air, it'll grow. Right now, the seed is opening, and a root is growing down, looking for water, while a sprout is pushing up, looking for sunshine and carbon dioxide in the air.
Whoa, cool!
Yeah, and now it will grow, thanks to photosynthesis.
What?
Photosynthesis. It's how plants make their own food. They use energy from the sun to turn water and carbon dioxide into sugar.
Whoa! Plants can make sugar from just water and air?
That's right. That's photosynthesis.
Oh, man. I wish I could make my own sugar.
Life's not fair, huh?
Guys, Something's happening over here. Is this the photosynthesis dingy?
You betcha! And as the plant eats the sugar, the stem grows taller and the leaves grow bigger.
Whoa! Awesome!
Yeah!
Photosynthesis makes a plant's food. Pollination's how they form new seeds, which fall on the ground and the stems pop out, and the entire plant life cycle repeats. A seed's just a seed, but it's brimming with potential. But to grow up, a few things are essential. Water, carbon dioxide, and the sun. That's what a plant needs to make its food through a process called photosynthesis. Now you've got a flower, bright colors and smells so sweet. And inside it hides a yummy nectar, too delish to resist for many a bumblebee, bird, or butterfly. So they just swing on by, and pollen from the stamen sticks to a making them a traveling pollen supply. And don't you know that some of that pollen is dropped on the pistil, the part of the flower with eggs inside that get fertilized by the pollen all around. Then they turn into seeds, finally falling. Photosynthesis makes a plant's food. Pollination's how they form new seeds, which fall on the ground and the stems pop out, and the entire plant life cycle repeats.
StoryBot fun fact number 37,802,629.
Did you know that in the country of New Zealand, there are more sheep than there are people?
We're now starting our tour of New Zealand. If you look to your left, you'll see sheep. But if you look over to your right, you'll see more sheep.
Excuse me, are we going anywhere without sheep?
Good question, driver.
We will follow you, cause we're sheep, sheep-a-deep, sheep-a-deep, sheep-a-sheepy-deepy sheep.
Here we go, we're all sheep. We stick with each other, you know we roll deep. When we're all together, they call us a herd.
Yes, a herd, no herd, H-E-R-D.
Word.
We're natural followers, like to be led. We'll follow a shepherd or a dog named Fred. We like to be apart when we're on our own. We get really nervous cause we're all alone. But the thing that really makes all us sheep rule, all of us sheep are covered in wool. That's the hair on our bodies.
They know that, fool.
Keeps us warm in the winter and summer, we cool. When they shave it all off, that's called shearing.
Check it out.
All my wool's disappearing. Can turn wool into hats, sweaters, and shawls. Socks, rugs, and gloves, even baseballs. A male is a ram, a baby is a lamb, a female is a ewe. I know who I am. No, a ewe. I get it now. Ewes are female sheep, this is a cow.
Eat grass and grains, chew it and swallow.
We'll go anywhere you lead and we'll follow.
Sheep, sheep-a-deep, sheep-a-deep, sheep-a-sheepy-deepy sheep. Sheep-a-deep, sheep-a-deep, sheep-a-deepy-deepy sheep.